Welcome to the Mission Control. I've got here, as I said, Gary Cox to talk with us about the epic computer upgrade that the crew has been working on. In particular, Dan Burbank has been upgrading a couple of the computers this week. And Gary is the epic program manager. So he's going to tell us what that's all about and why it's necessary and why it's good for the station. Thanks for coming, Gary.
You're welcome.
Okay, so EPIC, what does that stand for, first of all?
EPIC stands for Enhanced Processor Integrated Communications. Basically, it's a circuit board upgrade to the existing space station computers to help improve their performance and their memory margins and their CPU performance margins. As you know, the station's been on orbit for 10 years or so, and the original computers that were put up there are starting to feel the effects of mission ISS completion, where they're having more demands put on them. And so what we had to do was come up with a upgrade for those computers to give them more performance so they can handle this new configuration, as well as get us ready for future activation through 2020 and 2028.
Okay. Well, when you say computers, are we talking about like the laptops that we see the crew using, or is this the computers that run all the equipment on the station?
These are specifically the computers that run all the equipment on board. There's 47 of those computers on orbit. They're called MDMs. Basically, we looked at the top three or four types of computers that needed to be upgraded because of their performance was needed to be improved. And we identified our highest most computer called the CNC or command and control computer. It's the three computers that control the entire vehicle.
Okay.
So what we had to do is upgrade that computer along with a guidance navigation computer and, of course, payloads. We have a lot of science experiments that we've been adding over the years, and we wanted to make sure we had capacity to handle additional science.
Okay, so it's all about the science, which is not unusual for a space station, right?
Yes, that's right. We wanted to make sure we had no limitations getting through the next 10 to 15 years of operation, so we wanted to upgrade those computers to ensure we had proper capability for that.
Yeah, and I guess, I mean, 10 years is a long time for us to on the ground to go without getting a new computer or at the very least an upgrade, so...
Right.
Must have been about time.
Yes, these computers, again, have been operating for nearly 10 years, some of them a little bit more than 10 years, and have flawless operations, no problems. But one of the challenges we had to have, what we had to overcome, was coming up with an upgrade that didn't change the infrastructure, because we have a tremendous infrastructure built already with the software development and the testing that we have on the ground and the infrastructure within the station itself. So we had to be very careful when we upgraded these computers that we didn't upset that infrastructure.
Okay, that sounds complicated.
Yeah, it was quite a challenge, but it was as you saw, you know, back in just after Christmas when we started the additional upgrades, everything went very smoothly, and we're
right
now operating off the new computers.
Okay, great. Well, and I guess you've probably been working on this program for a long time, even before it launched, right?
Yes, we've been working on it for about 4 years
wow.
To make sure we had everything in place. We had a lot of testing on the ground, a lot of great support from Mission Control folks here, as well as the crew. The crew were involved heavily in installing these computer upgrades.
Did you know, how long ahead of time did you know that it was going to be this particular crew that was doing the work?
We knew about 8 months ago or so that
okay.
it was going to be Don Pettit and Dan Burbank.
So they had some time to practice on the ground before they went.
Yes,
okay.
Definitely.
And how difficult is it to actually perform this changeout in space?
What we do is we actually have to pull the computer out of the racks. All these computers are located in racks on the space station. We had to pull them out of the racks and put them on a workstation. That's kind of like a workbench, if you will. And then we had to pull front covers off, and then we actually had to pull single cards out and reinstall, much like you would do on a home computer when you install and change out computer cards.
Okay, I guess it's probably complicated a little bit by the lack of gravity.
The fact that you don't have gravity, and you got to make sure you're secure and doing the change out, and yes, it definitely makes it a little more complicated.
But so far, they've been going well, huh?
Everything went smoothly. We've got 7 computers that have been transitioned now, and everything's working just fine.
And you said there were how many in all?
There's 47 total computers. We only had to change out 7. We're looking to do a couple more in a couple of years that need to be addressed.
Okay. So is there any work left for Dan to do, or is he completely done then?
For this transition, he's done.
Okay.
He did a great job. Yes. Thank you.
That must feel really good to get that behind you.
Oh, yes. It was a major project. A lot of folks, a good team effort. You know, a lot of people were involved, including the crew, the astronauts, folks here in MOD, as well as engineering and the development side of the world. So, yeah, it was a big project.
So is there work left for you to do on the ground, or is you move on to something different now?
We're actually looking. I mentioned the two more computers we have to upgrade. That's going to be a challenge because those are outside computers. So yes, they're going to get the same EPIC upgrade, but they're outside. So we're going to have to do some EVAs where the astronauts, again, will be involved. They're going to have to go outside and pull these computers back inside and do a change out. And a little more complicated than this go around.
It sounds like it. Yeah, well, we'll be looking forward to that. I guess it's probably a little ways in the future still.
It's about 2 years or so away, yes.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much for coming and talking with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.